Hi there. My name is Sevag Demirjian. This presentation is part of an educational series about kidney medicine and extracorporeal support. Enjoy. Today, we'll be reviewing MART system for liver support, molecular adsorbent recirculating system. Let's start with basic dialysis circuit diagram, where we have the blood side and dialysate side. In a diffusion-based therapy, for simplicity, we have blood and dialysate running countercurrent. With MARS, a third circuit is added, which sits between the blood and dialysate. So in effect, albumin circuit is in contact with patient's blood on one side and regular dialysis on the other side. Within the albumin circuit, we have activated carbon and an ion exchange resin filters. To recap, we have the blood circuit, the albumin circuit, which is a closed circuit, and dialysis circuit. Next, let's review the setup on the actual machine. There is the add-on MARS module, which works with the CRRT machine. The CRRT blood pump draws blood from the patient and sends it first to the MARS machine hosted high-flux MARS flux dialyzer, and then returns to patient. The blood comes in direct contact with the albumin circuit via the MARS flux dialyzer. Then within the closed albumin circuit, solutes will travel first through the low-flux filter, then through the carbon and resin filters in their path. The last circuit is the dialysis circuit, which comes in contact with the albumin circuit in the low flux dialyzer on the PrismaFlex machine. To recap, we have the blood circuit driven by the PrismaFlex blood pump, the closed albumin circuit, which stays in motion via the pump on the MARS machine and goes through all the four filters. And last is a dialysate circuit, which clears the albumin circuit from typical low molecular weight and non-protein bound solutes such as electrolytes, urea, creatinine, and ammonia. Next, let's talk about the filters used in the MARS system. The MARS flux dialyzer is a high-flux polysulfone filter with large surface area and high molecular weight cutoff, but low albumin sieving coefficient. The ion exchange filter is likely a cholestyramine-based resin, which has high affinity to substances such as bile acid in exchange for chloride and ion. The charcoal filter is activated carbon material, which binds well to nonpolar and non-water soluble organic compounds. The last filter is a low-flux dialysis filter with regular size surface area, good for small non-protein bound solutes. This is really a quick review of liver toxins, which only covers the excretory side of liver function versus its whole other synthetic duties, which are extremely vital. As red cells break down and their components are recycled, bilirubin is generated and picked up by circulating proteins, which then are offloaded across the high flux membrane to circulating albumin on the other side. Same happens to cholesterol as it's converted to bile salts, as well as nitric oxide along with other substances. Another important group of substances that is handled by the liver is aromatic compounds, such as tryptophan and tyrosine, which are converted to indole and phenol products by gut bacteria and metabolized in the liver to picrassyl sulfate and indoxyl sulfate, which in turn are protein-bound solutes cleared by MARS. Of note, Your native kidneys are able to excrete these compounds, even though they are protein-bound, and are also considered uremic toxins. This concludes the talk about Mars system. Hope you enjoyed this presentation. Thank you.